Welcome to Radio Frequency and Microwave Laboratory. This is Prashant. In this video, we are going to discuss about radiation pattern of antenna. That is operational procedure, radiation pattern of horn antenna, and radiation pattern of parabolic antenna. Coming to the block diagram. First, we are going to connect klystron power supply with klystron mount. And it is connected to isolator, then variable attenuator, then frequency meter, slotted line section. Slotted line section is connected to the transmission part, and on air microwaves will be transmitted, and reception part we will be having another horn antenna or parabolic antenna that is connected to the detector mount, and finally output is taken across CRO or ammeter.
To perform this experiment, we require a table of setup which consists of klystron tube with source, test bench, horn transmitter, horn receiver, and digital ammeter. We know that before doing the experiment, we have to check initial conditions like in frequency meter, we have a pair of copper lines. By tuning this frequency meter, we have to set upside or downside. Coming to klystron power supply, beam voltage should be in minima position, reference voltage in maxima position, HT push pull button is in off condition. Coming to the modulation unit, AM, FM frequency amplitudes are in minima position. And transmitting receiving antennas are in line of sight. By tuning angular probe, we have to set in line of sight. Now we start experiment by switching on cooling form and measuring the values. Then after we have to turn on klystron power supply. After turning on klystron power supply, we have to press HT button. Then we are going to observe beam voltage, beam current, ripple voltages on this display by switching this meter selector. If we are putting into the voltage mode, we can see beam voltage, in current mode, current, and rippler voltage, rippler voltage. Now we have to set this video switching into current mode, and by varying beam voltage, we have to set current equal to 20 milli amps. After that, by switching modulation switch into AM mode, and AM frequency in mid position, AM amplitude is in mid position. At this time, you can observe readings on ammeter. To maximize that readings, we have to adjust regular voltage as well as amplitude of modulation. A. So after completing this task, we have to find the frequency. We know that direct method is easiest way to find frequency. By tuning this frequency meter, we have to observe ammeter readings. At one point, by tuning this frequency meter slowly, we can can observe a dip on ammeter. We have to set minimum position by doing this frequency meter. And right now we have to find value of frequency. In top of the frequency meter we have a vertical red line, and internal frequency meter we have two copper lines. In this between these two copper lines we are having some numerical numbers. This red line matches with that number is your current frequency, that is approximately 9.94 gigahertz frequency. So after taking the readout, frequency equal to 9.94 gigahertz, we have to detune frequency meter, and then we get Imax. So frequency is 9.94 gigahertz for this setup. After taking the reading of frequency, we have to calculate some calculations.
Now we are going to take frequency f equal to 9.94 gigahertz. And far field pattern is achieved at minimum distance of 2a square by lambda. By using this formula, lambda equal to c by f naught, where c equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second, that is velocity of light, and we have already find frequency value, that is 9.94 gigahertz. By substituting these two, we are going to find out lambda, where lambda equal to 3 into 10 to the power of 8 divided by 9.94 into 10 to the power of 9. So we will get 3 by 99.4, that is approximately 0.30, where lambda naught equal to 0.030. And we know that for far field pattern we require minimum distance of 2a square by lambda. So we found lambda, and a is a constant, that is inner diameter of horn antenna. So you can observe here, horn antenna consists of pyramidal type, and this is B and this is A. So wider will be taken as A. So this length is approximately 9.6 centimeters. By considering this value, we have to substitute in equation, that is 2a square by lambda. We know 2 into a is 9.6 into 9.6 divided by lambda, what we got, 0.3, which is approximately equal to 61.73 centimeters. Now we have to set distance in between transmitter and receiver should be 61 centimeters to get a far field pattern. Now we want to set the distance between
transmitter to the receiver is 61 centimeters to get a neat far field pattern. Offset the distance of 61 centimeters to the transmitter and receiving antennas. Now you can observe the readings. So while coming to the readings, it is approximately 190. So previously it is in 600 range. So whenever we are maintaining some distance, automatically receiving antenna power goes down. So now we have to check now. We are going to see the readings in clock direction and anti-clock direction. So this is the angular momentum while we are using this angular probe. Your antenna moves in a direction of that angle. So we have to take readings of those angular point to the amplitudes. To find radiation pattern of an antenna, we are going to move angular probe and corresponding values are going to be noted down in the paper, noted down in notes. At zero angle, output current is 187. Degrees 179, at 5 degrees 153, at 8 degrees 119. 10 degrees 85, 12 degrees 54, at 15 degrees 31, at 18 degrees is 17, at 20 degrees is 11. 25 degrees is 004 and at 30 degrees is 1 and after 30 degrees are 0. So these are the values we are taking in clockwise direction. Now we need to take for anti-clock direction. You have to take same for the same angles in anti-clock direction. For 2 degrees, for 0 degrees is 187. Degrees 132 degrees 135.
102, 348 degrees, 68, 345 degrees is 38, 342 degrees is 21, and 340 degrees is 12. And more than 330 degrees is approximately 0. So you can observe here, when we are shifting this angular probe, our horn antenna is going to be changed in that direction according to the angles we are plotting down. So here these are the values for horn antenna.
You can observe right now. These are the values for clockwise direction and these are the values for anti-clock direction. By using these values, we are going to plot the graph
of direction versus output curve. Then we will get a radiation pattern. So this is the method to find radiation pattern for ham antenna. To find out the directivity and gains of the horn antennas, we have sectorial horn antennas like E sectorial and H sectorial. Now we are going to see those things. To draw radiation pattern of horn antenna, we have another two types of antennas. So these two types of horn antennas, we are going to keep it receiver. We have to place in this model, so it is E plane and it is H plane. So in this pattern, we are going to keep your horns at receiving end and observe the same readings. According to this position, according to aperture, we are going to get a narrow band or wide band and different type of radiation patterns. Now coming to parabolic antenna, this is parabolic antenna. So instead of using horn antenna at receiver end, we are going to insert parabolic antenna at receiver end. So aperture of horn antenna is lesser than aperture of parabolic antenna. So in order, we will get a wider radiation pattern. So here and we are going to observe the readings on we have to check same pattern clockwise and anti-clockwise direction with parabolic antenna. For 0 degrees it is 143 and for for 0 degrees it is 205 203, and for 2 degrees it is 170 160. By tuning anti-clock direction and clock direction, we are going to take the readings for parabolic antenna. And how to plot rotation of angle versus currents obtained in ammeter. After the completion of experiment, we have to disconnect ammeter from detector mode, and we have to set initial conditions for frequency meter as well as Claystron power supply. That is, rippler mode is maximum, beam current is in minimum position, and amplitude frequencies of EM minimum position, history mode off, power off.
Coming to the measurement of radiation pattern. Frequency and radiation pattern for given horn antenna. Frequency is measured by using direct method, that is frequency meter, and it is approximately 9.94 gigahertz, and distance in between transmitter and receiver is calculated as d equal to 2a square by lambda, which is equal to 61.73 centimeters, where lambda is c by f naught, where c equal to 3 × 10⁸ meters per second, that is 0.30 meter per second. Coming to the observation of table, horn antenna while rotated in clockwise direction outputs in microamps. At 0 degrees we are getting 187, that is at 360 degrees also 187, 0 or 360 degrees. By increasing 2 degrees, we are going to obtain these type of values. At one point, it reaches to the 0. Similarly, here also in anti-clockwise direction, whenever degrees are changes, their corresponding values we can observe. By plotting these values into the graph, here we will get 0 to 180 degrees, and again it is rotated to the 360 degrees. 0, 10, 20, 30, 350, 340, 330, like in this manner. So here in between we will be having a dark line of circle, that is we going to connect, that is we are going to consider as units. By plotting these values, you will be getting in this type of pattern, 10 degree 20 degree 30 degree. Similarly, 350 340 330 degrees, these are the amplitudes: 40 60 80 100 120 140 160 180. So here we are getting approximately 187 as max. These are the clockwise direction readings, and these are the anti-clockwise direction readings. In the same manner, we are going to plot for parabolic antenna. Thanking you.